In this class, we are going to discuss about half subtractor. So, similar to half adder, this is going to subtract two single bit numbers. So, here see the definition of half subtractor. Half subtractor is a combinational circuit used to get the difference between two single bit numbers. Here, this is the block diagram of half subtractor, which is having two single bit numbers as input and two outputs. Those outputs may be difference and borrow. We know that when we are subtracting two binary numbers, sometimes we are getting borrow. That's why we need to consider borrow as one in output for any subtractor. So here, to design this functionality as a logic circuit, we need to consider truth table and then K-map. After that, by using expression from K-map, we are going to consider the logic diagram. So for this, as this half adder is having two inputs, so I am taking two inputs in truth table also, two inputs and two outputs. So here for two input variables, we may have four combinations. So that four combinations, you already know that 00, 01, 10 and 11. These are the all possible combinations with two input variables. Now for the functionality, which functionality we need to discuss here means subtraction. So here the subtraction between A and B we need to consider. So here if you are taking difference between 0 and 0, that is normal arithmetic subtraction, what you are going to get means 0. 0 minus 0 is equivalent to 0 only. Are you hearing any borrow means you are not hearing any borrow, then you need to put 0 in borrow place. So now you need to consider difference between 0 and 1. So 0 minus 1, in normal subtraction rules, 0 minus 1 means 1 with borrow 1. So here difference is 1 and you need to consider borrow 1 for that difference. So here 1 minus 0, in normal subtraction rule 1 minus 0 is equal to 1 only, there is no borrow. So here you are having 1 and no borrow here, and 1 minus 1 is equivalent to 0, you are not hearing any borrow in this case also. So just put 0 in borrow case, 1 minus 1, it's equivalent to difference equivalent to 0. So now you got your difference and borrow, which are the outputs of a half subtractor. Now you need to consider the K map for both difference and borrow to get the logical expression. So now I'm considering my K map for difference. So how many variable K map we need to consider, that will be depends upon the number of input variables. See here, the number of input variables here is 2, so you need to consider 2 input K map here. So I am just considering 2 input K map here, so that 2 input K map containing A and B, so which is having 4 cells, totally 4 cells. So for a 2 variable K map, you can observe 2 square cells, that means 4 cells. So now here in this K map for difference, where you need to put ones means wherever you are having ones in this column, there you need to put ones. So here I am having 1, where this 1 came means A equal to 0, B equal to 1. That means A equal to 0, B equal to 1 case, you are having 1. So here you are having 0, 1 and 0, 1 for both A, B. When A equal to 0, B equal to 1 means here, and now another one is there at A equal to 1, B equal to 0. A equal to 1, B equal to 0 means here. So here you can do diagonal grouping. As I told you, if total diagonal is covered by grouping, then you can take that as XR of that variables. That means you can take this as D is equal to A XR B if diagonal grouping is there. If you are not sure about this diagonal grouping, you can group individually and you can take the addition of that individual prime implicants. So by solving that expression also, you are going to get the same XR. So here D is equal to A XR B. So this is the expression came from the K map of difference. In the same way, we are going to consider K map for borrow. So now I am going to consider K map for borrow. K map for borrow. So this is also a two variable k map, because this borrow is also obtained from this input variables. So here I am considering same input variables a and b with combinations 0 1 and 0 1. These are the possibilities of a and b individually. So now see where you are having 1 in borrow place. Only one is there in borrow. That means borrow is coming only once when you taken two input variables. Where means when a equal to 0, b is equal to 1 in a minus b case. So that's why when a equal to 0 and b is equal to 1 place, I am putting 1. I am going to put 1. So here this is 1. And we are not having any ones to group with this one. So I am taking individual grouping of this one. This is one and only prime implicant in this K map. The value of this individual one will reflect the equation for borrow. So now the equation for this single prime implicant is, so sidewise it's covering 0, that 0 represents A means A bar. So 0 in sum of products means that is complement of variable. So here A bar top wise it's covering 1. 1 means B. So here borrow is equal to A bar B. So by using these two K maps, we came to know that the difference is equivalent to AXRB, that means XR of inputs, and borrow is equal to A bar into B. The only difference between half subtractor and half adder is, in case of half adder you are having this carry, that carry is equal to A into B, but in half subtractor we are having borrow, that borrow in A into B we are having complement of A. So now by using these two, I am going to draw my logic diagram for half subtractor. I am going to design the circuit finally. So here I am taking two input lines, so A and B I am considering. So here for A I am taking complement also. We can say this is A bar line, because as I take in inverter here, this will become A bar line. I am taking B here, this is B line. So these two are input variables and complement of A we require. So here to make the difference, you need to consider XR of A and B. You need to consider XR of A and B means you need to consider XR gate in between A and B. So now you are getting difference here. Now to get the borrow, what you are doing is you are considering A bar into B. That means you need a AND gate. This AND gate output is your borrow. So this is a half subtractor circuit designed by you by using truth table and K map. So like this you got this circuit. When you heard this half subtractor, definitely you are getting the circuit in your mind. But how this circuit came is, this is the procedure we need to consider to get this logic circuit for half subtractor.